Attendees will be shuttled around the city by self-driving taxis. They'll enter a newly built national stadium with the swipe of a pass, get verified by facial recognition software and be guided to their seats in one of 10 languages on a smartphone app. You may gaze up at the night sky from anywhere in Tokyo to see an artificial meteor shower show unfolding 50 miles above their heads. Concerted efforts are underway to realize these and other innovations and emulate the enviable legacy of technological superiority and reputation rebuilding that emerged from the last Summer Games Japan hosted in 1964. Olympic organizers, innovators, entrepreneurs and academics are working on ambitious projects that could enhance Japanese society and beyond. Long after the closing ceremony, the Olympic Games is a sports festival, but also it's a chance to show the innovation of scientific technologies, says Toshiro Muto, chief executive of Tokyo's organizing committee. He says the committee is planning high-tech features like hydrogen-powered vehicles for athlete transportation and smartphone tools to aid tourists. "We have the potential to make this Olympic Games wonderful, and one that the people of the world are going to admire. See all of the best photos of the week in these slideshows." Cities are increasingly reluctant to host the Olympic Games, given their hefty price tags. London 2012 cost $12.64 billion, the 2014 Winter Games in Sochi, Russia, reportedly topped $51 billion. Governments typically justify such huge spending by arguing it's paid back through increased tourism, marketing and other activity. Studies show this usually isn't the case, but successful post-Olympic legacies are possible. Los Angeles had a rare surplus in 1984, $232.5 million, Barcelona 1992 revitalized its waterfront, while London, heralded as the most digitally enabled games ever, laid down vital IT infrastructure. Japan originally budgeted $3 billion for the 2020 Games, but the organizing committee is currently reviewing the estimates. Japanese media report the total could be six times higher. Whatever the final figure, the country faces a big challenge matching the legacy of 1964. In preparation for the first Games held in Asia, lavish public spending, paid for with World Bank loans, fueled an era of motorization that expanded car ownership and infrastructure, propelling Japan's economic rise. The growing use of color televisions at the time, and the introduction with NASA's help of the first international satellite feed, created a spectacle that improved the country's global standing two decades after World War II. The 1964 Olympics had a huge impact in the global imagination of what Japan could be and would be, says Christian Tagsold, a scholar of modern Japan at Germany's Heinrich Heine University in Düsseldorf, Germany. Just 10 days before the start of the 64 Games, Japan launched the Shinkansen bullet train service. Over the ensuing decades, the still-growing and remarkably punctual network has carried more than 10 billion passengers without an accident and been replicated globally. It was the fastest train in the world and demonstrated Japan's re-emergence as a technological leader, says Paul Drewby, a historian of modern Japan at Manhattan College in New York. As the country now sets about replicating this success, it faces changed circumstances. The economy is no longer vibrant and is saddled with the highest debt burden in the industrialized world, and Japan's population has aged more than anywhere on the planet, causing the workforce to shrink. Analysts argue the Japanese government's once lofty ambitions have diminished considerably. "Unlike in 1964, I think there's a lack of grand vision," Drewby says. Japanese Prime Minister Shinzo Abe is trying to counter this view. At the annual Science and Technology and Society Forum last October, he envisaged a Japan where innovations spring up one after another, noting that its carmakers have built momentum in developing driverless technology. Abe made a bold prediction: by 2020, self-driving cars will be crisscrossing the streets of Tokyo. Abe's best hope of avoiding embarrassment may rest with Robot Taxi. The company, a collaboration between mobile and online services firm Dina and robotics company ZMP, is refitting existing vehicles with self-driving technology. "Its bet is that this will be more efficient than building new ones from the ground up." Robot Taxi is customizing the Toyota Estima, a minivan branded as the Previa in the US, but its method could be used on other models and manufacturers, according to a spokesperson. Later this month, Robot Taxi will hold 12 days of field tests involving local residents in the Kanagawa Prefecture, near Tokyo. Hiroshi Nakajima, head of automotive business at Dina, says the government has committed to passing laws regulating self-driving taxis by 2017, and the company hopes to have several thousand cars on the road for the Olympics. "The final number will depend on the stringency of the regulations, such as what roads the vehicles are allowed on," he adds. Japanese automakers, such as Toyota and Nissan, are also working on rolling out cars capable of some autonomous driving by 2020, but Nakajima believes his taxis can be early trailblazers by being fully self-driving and service-oriented. Company sees the Olympics as an ideal launchpad given its managed nature, geographic spread and tourist appeal. But the robot taxi service could eventually be applied to